OneNote for iPad got an update back in September, but we wanted to hold a webinar and make sure you knew about all the improvements. The most important thing to know is that you can now create notebooks on your iPad. Before, you had to create them in SkyDrive, and then your iPad could open them, but you actually can create them right on your iPad device. So let's show you how to do that. When you first install OneNote and you launch it, you'll log in with your Microsoft account, of course. But you get this sample notebook here, this welcome notebook. And this thing is really awesome when you're new. It shows you, it orients you to the program. It tells you how to get organized with notebooks. It tells you that each notebook contains sections. And this is actually worth taking just a quick look at, because a lot of times people get confused about the basic building blocks of OneNote. They get them sort of intermingled. Take a gander of this if you haven't. But one important thing to know about is that you're not stuck with this notebook. You don't have to customize this to make it your own. You can create a brand new one, a blank one from scratch if you want to. So what we're going to do is, to do that, we go up here to the upper left and we tap this arrow. And this is where you manage your notebooks. This is your list of notebooks. And here's the new feature here, create notebook. Okay, before you had to open them, but you can now create them here with your iPad. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna use a real simple example here. I'm gonna type class notes. And I'm gonna tap create up here. And that'll create the notebook up on SkyDrive. And here we go, we've got a blank, brand new notebook ready to be filled in. Okay, some other new features. You can make a new section by tapping the plus sign, okay? Tap that plus sign. You can name these sections real easily. You can double tap the section tab and type away. You can tap a tab. And also, instead of double tapping, you can just tap it and then get that rename button, okay? I'll name this math, real simple education example here. And then tap the tab, tap it again, and rename, and you've got English, okay? So that's how to create sections, that's how to name them. One of the common questions that people have been writing into office.com about is, how do I name a page? I think because they're used to doing stuff right on the tabs, right on the labels, so to speak, they're doing the same thing, they're wanting to tap and hold and name something on the right-hand side. Well, the way you name things in OneNote, you probably know this for those that have been using OneNote for a while, is you actually type in the page itself at the very top, and that's your name. So if I type January 28th notes, that'll autofill that file name over here, okay? One of the things I like to do for the name of a page, though, I like to insert the date. So up here at the top, I'm going to tap insert, and then I'm going to tap date right here, okay, then type notes. And now as I go along, I'm going to have these nice date formatted names over on the right. So we've created notebooks, we've created sections, now we're going to create pages. We're going to do that by tapping the new page icon here, and we can keep doing that if we need more pages. What else is new in this version? We can make auto-detected lists. So if we type in the page, and then I'll go to the Home tab just to illustrate this. If you tap one period and then a space, you'll see that something kind of magical happened there. That one period sort of looked more serious or looked more formal for a moment there. That means OneNote's now detected that you want a numbered list. And when you type a bunch of stuff and return and type a bunch of stuff and hit enter, it'll make those numbers for you. So I'm going to go ahead and type some stuff here. I'm going to say, I need to read pages. And then you can always use this handy dictation button here. Turn in paper by March 1st. Okay, great. So that is creating an auto-detected list there right in OneNote. Now let's address some tips, tricks, and some common questions, some more common questions that people have had when writing into office.com. One of them was, how do I delete a page? I think they're, again, trying to tap the tab on the right and seeing it. They want to see a delete button there. But the way you do it is you do it like you do when you delete email or delete iMessages, okay? You swipe to the left and then tap delete, okay? Swipe to the left, tap delete. And then one of the, you know, I saw a bunch of feverish comments about, hey, I deleted a page, how do I get it back? You cannot recover a page when you delete it here. So make sure you really want to delete it, okay? And the same with sections. People are wondering, how do I delete this section? Tap the tab, and you get that delete button, okay? And this, as well, is not recoverable. So make sure you really want to delete that section. The most common question that people ask is, how do I delete a notebook? So you cannot, at the moment, do that in OneNote for iPad, but you can go here and tap your back button to get to all your notebook management stuff. And if you want to just close a notebook so that it's not on your app for iPad, you can. You just swipe to the left, and then you've got that close button. But deleting it entirely, you'd have to go up to skydrive.com and in the Documents folder, and you'd have to delete it. There is kind of a cool app on the iPad called the SkyDrive app, and that does let you delete notebooks. So if you want to be on your iPad, you don't want to be in the browser, go ahead and install the SkyDrive app. Okay, so I'll tap that and open it up. And then I'll go to my Documents folder, and here are the two notebooks that are on my cloud storage. And if I wanted to delete one of these, I go up here to the upper right, and then I tap Select Items. And then I just select the notebook I want to delete, so I'm going to delete this one, select it, and then there's a trash can right here. So I'll just tap that. Now, it warns me, it says, are you sure you want to delete this? Because you're really deleting it. However, if you didn't mean to delete this, you could recover it from the recycle bin. So you've probably done that before, but up on skydrive.com, you would have to go to the lower left, go to recycle bin and recover it. You can't recover it here on this app, using this app or the OneNote app, but you could recover it if you wanted to. This app, I love the SkyDrive app. I can use it sort of as a launching pad for my notebook, so I have a bunch of different ones. I can go ahead and just tap one to open it, so I'll just tap this one, and it'll open it up in the OneNote app. And then, I don't know if people know this, but something I learned recently is that you can use four fingers to swipe, and you'll switch back and forth between the two applications. So, four fingers and four fingers. Another common question that people asked of office.com was, how do you rename a notebook? You can't do it here in the OneNote app, okay? There's no rename here, but you could go up to skydrive.com and rename it, or you could do it here in this SkyDrive app. You could go up to the three dots and select, like we did before, and then tap your notebook, and then there's these three dots down here in the lower right, and then you just tap rename this file. I'm going to rename it for Dave. Done, and it renames it for me, gives me the new name there. Okay, and then when you go back to OneNote and open that notebook up, your new name will appear right up here, Class Notes for Dave. Another thing that people asked us about is deleting list items. There's a lot of questions about deleting, recovering, renaming, and one of them was deleting list items. How do you do that without deleting the others? I think what's happening is people are, you know, tapping and then using this backspace key, and they hold it down, then they accidentally delete like part of the previous item. If that happens to you, you can easily select a list item just by triple tapping three times. If you know, double clicking a word in Microsoft Word will select just the word, right? So if I want to just March selected, I just double tap it, and just that word is selected. But if you triple tap a line in a list, it'll select that whole line. So I'm going to triple tap the bottom line here. 1, 2, 3. The whole line is selected, and now I can delete it easily. Okay? And that's helpful if you need to, like, also triple tap the line and then change this whole list from being numbered to maybe bulleted. You can easily do that with everything selected. And then finally, I think the most common question on office.com was, how do you get your notebooks onto the iPad? There seems to be confusion about that. If you're using OneNote for the PC, 2010 or higher, go to File, Share, log in with your Microsoft account, and then share it and save it up to that cloud location. And then when you're on your iPad, make sure to log in with that same account and password. I had a customer a couple weeks ago was having difficulty with this, and they had two separate accounts. So the way to make sure you're logged in with the same account is to go up here to the upper left and then make sure the account for SkyDrive is up here in your account for OneNote. If it's not, you could add another account here, okay? Or you could switch account, but just make sure you're logged into the same account and password, and your notebooks will show up here under Open. And then the other thing that's kind of tricky, it's really kind of a detailed thing here, but if someone shares a notebook with you, their notebook will show up under Open with a little shared by label here. Okay, that about wraps it up for our OneNote for iPad webinar. If you want more information about this app, go to aka.ms/onipad123, and there's extra information up there. There's links to how to get the app, and there's a cool video that also sums up the features. But come back next week, because on Tuesday, Doug Thomas is going to talk about Yammer. What is Yammer, in fact, is the subject. And what I'll talk about is how to use Yammer, which is a really cool social network for companies, so that people can collaborate and get stuff done at work. Very special thanks to the webinar team today. We have a lot of helpful PMs on the line. Michael Higashi helped us out with the camera work today. Thanks everyone very much, and stick around for the Q&A. We'll answer all your questions.